How's it going, guys? Splover King here, some more NASCAR The Game 2011. And I just discovered that I can actually see like my stats for the season, so I have this open right now. Looks like I have an average finish of 7th, which is really good, actually. Wait, last race, 5th? Oh, maybe it was the last race before Pocono. I was like, I finished 12th in the last race. But I got 3 wins, 8 top 5s, 10 top 10s. In however many races it's been, 14, 15, something like that. So really good stats. If this was real life, I probably would be the points leader too. But I wonder, can I see like other people's stats? Yeah, I can. Ooh, Jimmy Johnson's had almost equally as good of a season as me, except when he probably doesn't finish at top 10, he probably finishes like dead last. But I wanna see, who has a win outside of the top 10 here. I'm sorry, I'm going to waste time doing this, but it's okay. So Dale Jr. didn't have one. Greg Biffle doesn't have one. Dave Ruhman doesn't have one. There's Jamie Mack. Carl doesn't. And Joey, of course, doesn't, because back in this time he sucked. Martin Truex doesn't. Matt Kenseth doesn't. He's doing really bad, actually. Clint Boyer doesn't. Does anybody in here? And of course, freaking Ryan Vickers doesn't. Average finish 20th. That's why he's in 20th. Oh well, whatever. So this week, Michigan International Speedway, like I said last time, is my home track. We change the things up. I'm going to do 2x the wear, double the wear. See how it goes. Maybe I'll like it, maybe I won't. Jimmy Johnson on the pole again, a lap time of 38.14. Hopefully he doesn't dominate the race like he did at, it seems like the past two races, actually. I think Kyle Busch and Jimmy Johnson led every single lap. So let's try to change that. Let's also try not to wreck, like, right at the end of the race. I'm still salty about that Kansas race. Even though I had a whole nother race full of wrecks, I still can't believe I did that. I'm gonna look like such a retard when I post a video, because I'm willing to bet when I watch it later it's because I did something incredibly stupid. Dang, look at all those races I've done here. You can tell I really like it. But a lot of those are definitely crashes. Michigan International Speedway is definitely not in the very center of Michigan. It's more near Detroit. And it's the hell of a good Sour Cream Dips 400. God, I'm gonna have to freaking type that out. The Dover one, I didn't type out the whole thing. I was too lazy, but this one I might have to. But whoa, Eric Almirola, nice. Getting a, what would that be? A 40th place qualifying run instead of a 41st? Nice job. And here we go. Usually when I go to this track, I usually sit more towards like the end of this first grandstand. So like right around there, that's where I usually sit. That's when the cars are going the fastest. I mean, you gotta sit where they're going the fastest. And why am I just following these guys on the bottom? That does not seem like the right thing to do. Oh, crap! Sorry, guys. Whoa! There goes Danica. Ooh, she's in the wall. Whoops. And oh, there's a caution. Probably because she stopped. Boop. Well, first caution, and it technically was caused by me, because I like slammed in the back of, I think it was Kevin Conway. Well, let's give this another shot then. It's kind of like another start to the race. We didn't even make it down the backstretch. Back the green. I'm going to try to do the high side, because they're probably going to check up again. Yep, they did. I'm just gonna swing to the inside. Has a whole bunch of cars. Ooh, we better hope there's not a, like, 2 green and white checkers. I just, looking at the fuel, I only have 21 laps left. So if this race goes more than 24 laps, it might get a little bit hairy. pretty sure. Yeah, this game doesn't have. Again, I think I discussed this earlier, but I don't think it has a clutch. So no saving fuel. Get out of here, Brad. This is my home track, not yours. Woo! A little loosey-goosey. Alright, now let's try to get into a little bit of a rhythm. Jeez. Bobby Labonte, like, dove it into that turn. Ooh, I've got a really good lap going. Oh, still not enough to beat Kyle Busch's, though. 212. Yeah, this track is really fast, even in this game. Got this nice highlighting working. Ooh, sorry, Matt. Jeez. I don't know why they were checking up so much. We were already on the straightaway. And somehow I'm still like half a second faster than my other lap. And there's Brian Vickers in his typical 22nd, 23rd position. Swoop down here. Dang, I still don't have the fastest lap. Probably because of what happened in down the backstretch. Bit loose, but that kind of helped me dive into these cars. I'm gonna feel nice and push David Ruderman here. I would love for him to make the chase. Oh crap, screwed up the entrance to that corner. There's like these like two dips in turns 3 and 4 at this track where it makes it really hairy, and man, I have a way faster lap going this time. Wait, oh, I didn't even realize, but I was like a second off the pace. I could barely tell the difference between the 38 and the 39. But I'm really close to Greg Biffle's time. What place is he in? Hey, how do you pass David Ruderman already? David Ruderman, where are you? Or is he? No? Oh, wow. I try to be nice to him, and he just screws up. Beautiful. Just that second dip. Just gotta hit the gas. So in between videos, I just read on NASCAR.com that, of course, freaking Casey Kane, he finally gets another top five, only his second of the year, and of course, something had to go wrong, and they fail post-race inspection, and he was in the chase by like 2 points, and now he's out by like 13, because he got a 15-point penalty, so he might as well just finish 19th like he has all season. But I'll still take a top five, like I'm not complaining too much. I'll definitely take half the field wrecking to get him a top five. I am upset, though, that Kyle Larson didn't win. Like it was still technically an exciting finish with him racing that hard, but it's less exciting because a guy who's already won, like, 40 times won. But, man, it would have been nice if, like, Kyle Larson would have won, or Chase Elliott. I technically like Chase Elliott more, but Kyle Larson probably deserved to win that race more than... Whoops, sorry, got loose there, Jamie. But he probably deserves a win more than Chase Elliott did. Because he definitely had a faster car than both of them. He just had to screw around trying to pass Matt Kenseth for like 20 laps. But either way, it was exciting at the end. It was boring when Kevin Harvick and all those guys were dominating the race. So I am always in favor of taking out all the fastest cars about 3/4 of the way through the race. Because this season, Casey Kane will not be one of the fastest cars, so it usually won't affect him. Now I'm really hoping that these next 2 weeks at Charlotte, he shows some speed. I mean, it's his best track. I'm pretty sure last year he even won a segment in the All-Star race, so... make me proud for at least one race, Casey, please. And even with this double wear, I'm still making my way through the pack. But probably a little bit slower than I would have if I just had standard tire wear on. But I guess it just shows that how much I've raced here. Getting a little bit loose there. But it doesn't really look like on the indicator that there's too much tire wear. I'm sorry if my voice keeps getting like louder and softer and louder and softer. It's because I keep like moving around. Sometimes I lean to the right, sometimes I lean back to the left. Because my mic is on the left side of me. Which, did I already pass Kurt Busch? I think I did. Pretty sure last time I said I was gonna like try to make him blow over, but whatever. Maybe we'll get him at Daytona. Or I could try to do it at Sonoma. Though, I don't necessarily recommend doing that. It looks like my tires have evened out to where I really have to race these guys now. Who's in front of me there? Jeff Burton. I think I'm going to keep it at times two. Not for Sonoma, though. No way. No way am I going to do it there. If there's one thing I'm definitely terrible at in these games, it's the road courses. I just cannot get a feel for them at this game whatsoever. Dang, those guys are following me up here. There's Jimmy. Well, she started on the pole, so he's not going to win this race. Ooh, got a good run there. I was going to go to the outside, but it looked like he was going to go up there, and I guessed right. And they're racing pretty hard up there. Looks like it might be Kyle Busch, Jeff Gordon, and Kevin Harvick, maybe? A lot of good racing, though. That's why I like this track. You can race side by side fairly easily and not wreck. Yeah, I should definitely be good on fuel. I almost said something, but I don't want to say it, because it seems like every time I say something like that, I jinx it, so I'm just going to keep my mouth shut and just try to race these last five or six laps and focus. I'm sure you guys know what I'm talking about, because it seems to happen every race as soon as I say something good. Things happen, so I'm not going to do it. But I will say this. Swear to God, Kevin Harvick better not win this race. Pretty sure he's already won, though. I think it was Richmond. Ooh, he got a good run on me. My car's starting to get really loose now. Don't think I have anything for that top five. It's really sad because like a lot of that grandstand there is gone now in Michigan. And I was talking to my dad about like the attendance stuff like lately, and it's just been so sad watching all the races and seeing how empty the stands are. Because he was telling me back when I was like 7 or 8, like it was nearly impossible to get tickets to this track. And I remember going to a couple races when I was really young, and it literally, like, I'm not even joking, taking, like, it's about, with no traffic, like, from my house to the Speedway, like, it's maybe 2.5 hour drive. Like, we'd have to leave really early, because we'd get there, we'd be within 5 miles of the track, 10 miles of the track, but that last 5 to 10 miles would take us, like, 3 hours, because all it is a two-lane road, and that's it. Just one lane per direction. They'd obviously would close down the other lane and make it, whoop, crap, why'd I do that? But they would close down one of the lanes and make it so people can go in the passing lane, technically, or the reverse lane, whatever I'm trying to say. But even then, still wasn't enough. But now, it's really easy to get to the track since it's not near as popular as what it used to be. Homestead was definitely the best track for traffic because it was a newer track, so they kind of like built around the infrastructure it needed to have. How many people go to Homestead? I think 90,000 is what it holds. So Homestead's still my favorite track. I loved going there when I lived in Florida. I went there every year from like 2006 to 2009, I think, 9-10. I think it was 2009. One of the years, I think it was 2008, I went to all three of the races that weekend. It was really fun. We stayed in a hotel. It's probably one of my favorite NASCAR weekends ever. Even though my favorite driver, Case, I mean, he didn't win. I think he got like a top 10 in the cup race, but that was about it. But it was the year that Johnny Benson won his truck championship. So me and my dad were super stressed out being in the stands that night. Obviously being from Michigan, just like Johnny Benson. Oh, so last lap. And Tony Stewart, yes, get by Kevin Harvick, please. I'll love you forever. Ooh, and maybe I got a shot at a top five here. So it looks like Kyle Busch is checking up. He was pushing. Ooh, probably a bad move going to the inside. I hit the brakes big time. Should I get a really good run? Coming off the turn. Eh. Ooh, come on. Oh, did we get it? No. Man, that was close. We probably tied again, but this time I was on the wrong end of it. Whew, but I'll take a sixth place. So it was a hard-fought sixth. It's not like I just drove my way up through the pack. I just had to be patient. And Jamie McMurray, where did you come from? Why is he... He's still going. Like, the race is still going on. And yeah, we did tie. But it looks like they must have thought he was in front. Jeez. Oh, well. At the very least, Kevin Harvick didn't win, so thank the Lord above for that. And we're doing our weekly Let's Wreck as we're doing the pace laps after the finish. So, yep, Tony Stewart wins. Came in 6th, Denny Hamlin 7th. And Age Allmendinger, nice run for him. And where's Jamie Mack? Like, how did he just go flying through the pack? Oh, hey. Brian Vickers sticking to tradition. I can't even speak right now. Sticking to tradition, finishing 20th. It's definitely tell it's like my bedtime. There's Kurt Busch, ha, finishing 27th. Little scumbag. Was Jamie Mack a lap down? Pretty much. Why? And wait, where? How come did people die? Oh, they're just finishing right now. Maybe that's why those people weren't popping up before. When did we lap these cars? I don't know. I'm not gonna question it. I'm done. I'm hashtag done. Cool, Jegs. I don't know what I did, but thank you. Thank you so much. And Tony Stewart's chipping away at that lead again. Gained it by about 5 points. Oh, Kevin Harvick, oh. Let's see. Ooh, Juan Pablo Montoya gapping Dale Earnhardt Jr. a little bit more. Boo, gonna keep going. Brian Vickers keeps dropping back. Whoa. Jennifer Jo Cobb, her bid for a top 30 points finish is probably gonna fall short now. She lost a lot of ground finishing almost last. And Danica Patrick finally breaks a streak. Beats her. Whew. Yeah, I'm gonna have to call it a night. I'm getting tired. Sucks I didn't win at all in this session. I'm gonna finish 5th, 12th, and 6th. So a little bit worse than I had been the past couple times, but I'll still take it. It's not like I finished 30th or anything. I still haven't finished that far back. What's my worst finish? I'm gonna go back real quick. Boo. 9th. 18th, possibly. Yep, 18th. And that was what, Bristol? I think it was, yeah. I don't know. I've already passed Bristol. So next week, it's the dreaded Infineon Raceway. Like I said, I'm definitely not going to be doing times to wear there because this will be probably my worst finish of the season. So. Get ready for some carnage and get ready for some fail, because it's probably not going to be pretty.